Alright, I do believe I found out why this switch down here is not working. They have a switch for the sub pump as well, and they broke the yellow wire here and put in the float switch between A and B to break that circuit in case the float switch in the sub pump actually opens up. But at the same time, they took this switch and connected to the same two terminals as this was right here. So that means both of them switches have to be open for it to shut the system down. It's got to be in series, so don't matter if one or two actually open up, it shuts the unit down. So that explains why I can take this switch and turn it upside down. It did not turn it off because the other switch in the sub pump still connected and still connecting the outdoor unit with power. So let's change that and check this switch again to see if it actually would turn the unit off. Okay, I got all back together, got it turned on, and I left that switch out so it will treat it as if it's actually triggered to shut the unit off. So now we're going to put it back in and see if the outdoor unit will come on. I should know that by when I hear the flow actually in the lines. Now all the screws are in. They said they sent somebody else about a month ago when they had the exact same problem. So apparently they just cleaned out the trap that goes from here. Oop. All right, we got the outdoor unit coming on. So that's all it was. Somebody wired it wrong. You got to put them in series instead of parallel to get each switch to operate on its own, breaking the circuit. So now we got to go pick up a accumulator and a compressor and go change that out and get another one up and running.